We have just defined an event as a subset of outcomes, an event A as a subset of omega, the overall set of all possible outcomes. This is, in fact, a very convenient way to define events because we can use set operations to come up with a lot of more events. For example, in the previous example, we can talk about A intersect B. That in language is we want to look at all the outcomes that has the second coin flip as a tail, and at the same time, there has to be at least one head. In this case, it's this single element set. It has to be first is a head, there has to be at least one head, then the second one is tail. We can talk about union of two sets. For example, A union C. That means we need to have either the second coin flip is a tail or both coin flips are head. So this is head head in C, HT, TT. So this defines a more complex event. Or we can define a set's complement. For example, B complement. That means event B didn't happen, there is not at least a head in the two coin flips. So in this case, it has to be TT, it's a single element event again. There are two special events in every model. One of them is omega itself, the whole set. Let's include all possible events. So whatever is the outcome, this event always occur. And the complement of that is phi. This is what we use to define empty set. So it means no outcome is counted in this event. There are some nice properties of the probability of these events. Now let's list some of them. Properties. Number one, we will always have probability of the whole set make it equal to 1. The probability of some outcome happens, that's a sure thing. That has probability of 1. For that reason, probability of the empty set, we always define that as 0. The second property is, if I have one event included in a different event. This event A is a subset of B, then I always have probability of A is less than or equal to probability of B. Because in the definition, the probability of this event is the sum of the probability of all elements in it. And it has more elements, and each one has a non-negative probability with it, so the sum is always larger. So this requires that every probability of every event, because A is always a subset of omega, this has to be always less than or equal to 1. That's from this definition. And third one, also important, is if I have two events that they do not overlap, meaning their intersection is empty set. And this would imply, if I look at the probability of the union of the two, I want to include all the outcomes in either A or B, but there is no overlap. And this is equal to probability of A plus probability of B. Right. Simple consequence of this is because A and A complement always do not overlap, and they union up to omega. So we can write probability of A complement is always equal to 1. This is the probability of omega, the whole set, minus probability of A. So here are some simple properties of probability. In fact, the probability of event is so convenient that later on, when we write probability of a omega of one element, we actually think of that as probability of a single element set. Think of that as this event that has only one single element. So in this way, we can say probabilities are only defined for events. That's a better way to write probabilities.